Hey, it's DJ Rainstorm here with a video about BeamNG Drive, a game where you can drive around and crash and stuff. So we're going to start with this race car, a little race car here. Now, this is my first video ever, and, I don't really know. Let's just drive around a little bit, you know. You can really think about more stuff. You can really think about more of seeing more videos of this later on, but I have a lot of games that we can play, so. If you request anything that I have, then it's probably going to be good. Oh my lord, this car is really loud. Anyway, let's just continue on driving, and. Okay, this is going to be the most momentary thing, the most important thing in my YouTube career. The first crash in BeamNG Drive ever. Was really bad. Anyway, now you can pretty much see how this kind of thing handles. I can't really explain how it handles, but let me just get a better crash attack so we can really see the physics of this game. As you can see here, it's pretty realistic, but it's still in beta. It's all good though. This game is really fun, and I think that we can make a few more videos of this. Possibly? I don't know. Anyway, let's get on with this. This is the, what is this game? I don't know what this car is. Oh yes, this is the Abishukova. Let's go through all the vehicles, starting with this one. Now, I'm not going to go through all the versions of this, because there's a lot of versions. You know, drag, and this is the normal version that you start with. Now we're going to drive along to see how this thing handles. There's a bunch of different... let's just go over the cars. There are this camera angle, then you go back to the default one. Those are all the camera angles for this, for all the cars. This is one of the cars that we're going to be looking over today, so let's just drive around a little bit, then crash it. Now, there are more than one maps like this. There's a few maps that we can go to, but this is just my favorite one, personally. So, we're gonna have a great time in YouTube. It's my first video, so everything is it's all good. Oh my word, I just broke my wheel off, and then crashed. Now, sometimes it gets a little glitchy, like right there you can see. Anyway, I'm still kind of a beginner with this game, but I've been playing long enough where I know what to do. This is the newest vehicle that was added just a month ago, called the Burnside Special. It was made in 1953, and it's old, and really hard to drive. Its handling is so bad. It's like, I mean, how do you drive this thing? It's like a drift-o-matic. Anyway, let's just drive this thing for a little bit and get the feeling of it. Anyway, this handling is so terrible. So I'm not going to use this car in many of my videos because of how freaking terrible its handling is. Anyway, let's move on to the next car called the Abishu 200BX. Hopefully I'm pronouncing this right. Let's just start with the base one. There are a couple other versions, but I'm really just going over a quick overview of these vehicles. Maybe later on I'll do a showcase for these vehicles in case you want to know more about them. Now let's get to driving this thing. As you can see, all the gauges function just like all the other vehicles in this game. All the gauges function and stuff. Oh, and another little fun thing you can do with these cars is you can do this. You can set them on fire and have fun. You can drive them around and set them on fire. You can also deflate the tires, break all the hinges, or break all brake groups, and you go sliding along like this, and then you stop, and then you're just on fire. And or you could just ignite. What? That probably was not supposed to happen. It's supposed to ignite. There we go. Anyway, let's. Still on fire? You know. Let's go on to the next vehicle called the Gavril Grand Marshal. I'm just hoping that I am able to pronounce these right. This vehicle is really awesome. It's pretty strong, but let's just go around this thing a few times, and then we can see the camera angles. Everything looks nice and pretty, and it's a pretty nice interior. I should probably get to the interiors, but right now I'm just going over a quick, very quick overview of these vehicles. I'll do videos for them later on, as I mentioned before. This is going to... Okay, let's just drive this around, I guess. Sorry if my way of talking is annoying, because this is my first video ever, so I'm probably going to look back this in a few years like I am a total idiot at YouTube. Well, back then, but in the future I'm going to be like super, super rich and awesome and mega, super, ultra, mega... Okay, maybe I should just stop. I'm going to hurt myself. Anyway, this car is pretty powerful, so it's a little hard to get with, but when you have a keyboard driving in this game, there is no half throttle, or like, it's only full throttle. You go like, drift out, you go like, burn out every time you try to speed up. Anyway, let's continue to the Ibishu Covet, which you saw a little bit of when I drove the turbo rally around. Let's just start with the one you start off with at spawn, the default. Now, this car looks pretty nice, right? Little small car. Anyway, let's get in this thing and start driving around a little bit. I like that screen wheel so much. Dang it, that's a little loud, isn't it? This game has some custom sounds to it, like this car. Oh crap, it just lost a wheel. Now you saw a little crash there, I guess. Now let's continue to, let's skip over these mods. They're not actually part of the game, they're just mods. So let's get rid of those, let's not do those. Let's go to the Ibishu Pessima. Yeah, Ibishu Pessima, I don't know what I'm talking about. I don't know what I'm talking about, but no idea how to pronounce this, I'm just hoping. Now, isn't this fun? Now let's just continue along here, driving into this car so that we can see how this kind of thing performs. This is like your basic, most boring, bland economy car. It's like front wheel drive, I think. But it's the bland economy car. And now that we've seen it first crash, it's all good. It's good. So now let's go on to the next car called the Bruckel Moonhawk. Now none of some of these vehicles exist in real life, but they couldn't copy off the names from those cars, so they had to make up their own names because otherwise it would be like copyright or something, so not very good. Anyway, we get a feel of how this drives. You see, this is not very safe. There's no seatbelts or anything in this car. You can't see any, right? Some of them do have little slots where a seatbelt would go, but this is one of those older cars with no seatbelts and stuff, so it handles pretty badly. All the older cars do, but most of these cars are from the 1900s, 1990s, but this is the 1970s here. This car handles pretty terribly. Now let's get our first crash on this bridge over here. Now, yeah, let's crash, and as you can see, it looks pretty nice, doesn't it? I think it looks pretty nice. Anyway, now that we've gone over that vehicle, there's quite a few other versions we can go into, like the Dragman. That thing's so fast. Now we got this car, which actually is the only car in here with all-wheel steering in the whole game. This thing has all-wheel steering. As you can see, when we steer, these wheels move so that you can get extra stability or something. Although they only move a little bit, so it's not too helpful. But it helps with stability for now. Anyway, let's drive this thing around a little bit. As you can see, it has all those camera angles I showed earlier. Let's continue on our journey through BeamNG Drive, first video. Now, crash into this house, and you can't interact with any of the environment. I mean, it all just stays as the way it was. There's no denting or anything, although since this game is still in like alpha versions, it's probably okay. As you can see, this car doesn't look very safe now, does it? That roof bent, which means that people are going to be a little crushed in there. Anyway, now that we've gone over this vehicle, let's go to this car called the Pigeon. In real life, it's actually called the Robin, the little three-wheeled tank. It's actually it's the only car in the tricycle thing. Now, this thing tips over at like 40 miles per hour. As you can see there, this thing sucks. It has a warning, like, right there, if you can read that. Warning, do not make a steering sharply at the high speed. And this thing can't go very fast. As you can see, this is the stupidest car ever. Oh my gosh. And it doesn't have the normal, like, it only has this one, and this one. So it's missing a few of the other camera angles because of its stupidness. And then you can see an example of what happens when you turn too sharply, it tips. Oh my word, this thing is so durable. I see. Now, if you really want to know about BeamNG Drive a lot more, go to this channel called YBR. He does really great videos on this game. Now we have the Hirochi rear wheel. Wait, what is this? Oh, it was the Hirochi SBR4. And this car is really fast. Let's just say, really fast. You can hear that turbo there of like high pitched squeal. That's what turbo sounds like. Oh crap, this thing is so fast. We're already at 100 miles per hour. Oh crap. That tree. Oh, man, that's gonna hurt. That's gonna leave a mark. Now, this car is really fast and durable, but I mean, at 100 miles per hour, no car is gonna survive that. Now, now that we've gone over this thing, let's go to the next vehicle. The Hirochi Sunburst, which you saw a little bit. Oh wait, I don't think I showcased this yet. Nope, no I haven't. We're gonna go for the sport version with a little lippy bit. And now we're gonna drive, oh crap. Now the controls are very simple, we can look over them later, but in a later video, but right now we're just kind of playing around with this game. I've had this game for quite a while now, so I know all the things good. Now scratches on a tree! And we died. Probably. Look at that front. That engine doesn't like that. Got a little spiky bit there. A few spiky bits, actually. Anyway, let's go to the next vehicle. The Civetta Bolide. I honestly don't use this car much because it's not very stable, and it's really fast. As you can see, this is definitely a DeLorean. Everyone knows it. Everyone knows your secret. And it's really bad handling. It's so bad that I can't even explain how bad the handling is on this thing. The only way to be able to drive it is on the 320M's version. It's even possible to drive this thing without spinning out. This thing is like really powerful, so this is the most. This is like the weakest version. Oh, so that's really good there. You got a few crashes. Now let's go to the Gravel D series. We have a lot of trucks here. We'll go over these later, in a later video or something. Anyway, let's just start with this car. This vehicle is the default truck, and it can drive well. Good handling. And this is honestly not my favorite vehicle. My favorite is the Ibisu Covet, which those were just a few minutes ago. I crashed. I flipped over. How did I do that? Anyway, I was just gonna crash into this tree really quick, so you can get a feel of what these crashes look like for this one. Now, the windscreen didn't break this time, which is kinda odd, but alpha version. Now let's go to the Gavril Roamer, which is really just an extended cab of this car. I mean, it has a different interior, but yeah, it just has an extended back little bit right there. And let's drive this thing into a tree or something. There's only trees around here, so we can find a ditch right over here. I know this map really well, because I've driven this road so many times. Oh crap. Oh, I didn't expect that. Anyway, you can see it crashed there. We could be upside down in here. Woo! Anyway, let's go on to the next vehicle. The Gravel T series, which is really just a big rig, you know. They're coming up with really weird names for these vehicles. Anyway, this is the only long bed version you can get, so you can't get those big rigs, like really long, super long stuff. You can only get this. Let's drive this thing now. It's not fast. I was just saying that now. It's not fast, and its crashes aren't really that good to what you'd expect in real life. Honestly, I never use this vehicle, so if you're like demanding to see it, I guess I'll listen to you then. But right now, I prefer not to. As you can see, I don't like these crashes. There's not much here to crash with. Besides the cab, it's just kind of bland. I don't really like it. Now, the last vehicle, we'll go over the props, like, in a later video. Again, lots of later videos. We have this thing. We have this van. This fanny bed. I don't know. Something. This is a little thing here. Woo! Let's crash into a tree. Boom. Now, this thing is really safe. I really like this vehicle, and I use it a lot. Let's go to the next version of the cabster. We got the cabster right here. The cabster. As you can see, the interior is the same, but you got this thing sitting here in the back. And you're probably gonna... Oh, it crashed. That's not good. As you can see, it looks exactly except for that in the front. It looks exactly the same in the front, except for this little back part. So, that's all the vehicles for now. And you can actually change the time. Oh, wait, not in this map, but we can show that off later. Can you please stop rolling away? Anyway, now you can change the gravity. Let's say we're on the sun. Then that happens. Let's say we're on negative Earth, and then Earth, and then we fall down. Like this. This is fun. And then that happens. Isn't this fun? And after a while, it starts to look like a pancake if you keep doing it. Now it gets a really glitchy. As you can... Oh, oh no. Oh my gosh. Oh crap. Oh no, what is happening? What was that? What was that? I don't know what that was. I don't know what that was. I have honestly no clue. Anyway, you can see, and still, that's a good example of what it's like in beta. Now that we've gone over all the vehicles, I really don't know. Like, we got all this stuff over here. Oh yes, the controls. Well, change log is here, like, things they changed. As you can see, in version 0.1.5, this car, the Burnside Special we saw earlier, was released. Now, help. We can, what? Oh, wait. The controls are right here. There are a lot of controls. And I honestly don't use most of them. Anyway, these are all the controls that I know of. If we want advanced controls, then we're gonna have a lot more. And here, we got a lot of controls now. We got all these things right here. I don't know what to do with them, but I don't really care either. Then you can hear there's a bunch of stuff like static collision. I have no idea what that means. So you got, I've never been in here before. I have no idea what that is. I don't know what that is either. Oh my word, some of this stuff I've never used in my life. Feedback. You can message the stuff. And with this mode, you can fly around and take pictures of stuff really slowly and precisely very well. And you can take pictures and stuff with little buttons. Anyway, that's really all I have for this video. Just a little introduction to BeamNG Drive. Now, if you guys request any games in the future, I really don't have that much money to buy them. But I do have quite a bit of games in my Steam account. Like 74. So we can play those anytime. Now. Anyway, that's it for this video, I guess. And, bye!